Hey, how's it going everybody? It's your bro here, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys how we can create some very simple 2D animations in Java, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Let's get started, people. So, with this video, we're only going to be moving an image around on the x-axis and the y-axis. We're just going to be covering some very simple animations by use of a timer, so it's not going to be anything that sophisticated. Now before we begin, here's my setup that I have. I have three classes, a class called Main, a class called MyFrame that extends JFrame, and a class called MyPanel which extends JPanel. Within the Main class, I have an instance of MyFrame. Within MyFrame, I have an instance of MyPanel called Panel, and within the constructor for MyFrame, I instantiated this panel. For this MyFrame, I have this.setDefaultClose operation, JFrame exit on close. We're going to add this panel to the frame, and we're going to be painting on the panel itself. Followed by this.pack, this.setLocation relative to null. This will allow the frame to appear in the middle of your computer screen. And lastly, this.setVisible is set to true. We're going to be finishing everything else within this MyPanel class. So, we have a constructor for MyPanel. We're going to declare a few things outside of this constructor. So let's begin with the panel width and the panel height, because we'll want to know what the limitations are of the image that we're moving. We'll want to know the bounds that we have. So I'm actually going to make this a final integer for the width and the height. So let's say final int panel underscore width, and let's set this to 500. And we'll do the same thing for height. Panel height. And we'll make this 500 as well, so this will be a square. So we're going to need an image. Image, we'll call this image. Actually, better yet, let's call this enemy, because I'm going to be moving this enemy icon around within the panel. So let's call this enemy instead, just so it's easier to differentiate. I'm also going to use the space background as my background. So I'm going to make an image called image, background, image, and we'll do this last. That's all one word though. We're going to need a timer, so timer, timer. Int x velocity, so we can adjust how far or how many pixels this image is moving on the x-axis. Let's set this to 1 to begin with, and we'll do the same thing for y-velocity. And we'll have a starting x position, and we'll set this to 0. And the same thing with y. Int y. And that should be it for now. Now within the constructor, we're going to finish instantiating a few things. Let's begin by setting the size of this panel. Since we're using the pack function, we'll want to set preferred size. So this.setPreferredSize, and we pass in a new dimension. And we can use panel width and panel height for that. So let's pass in panel width and panel height. And this should appear. Yep, here's our panel that's added to our frame. And we're going to be drawing on this panel. So the next thing that we should do, let's set the background color just because we can. This.setBackgroundColor. Eventually, if you have an image, we'll replace the background color with the image that you have, if you have one. Let's set this to color.black. And let's finish instantiating this image, and it's called enemy. Enemy equals new image icon. And then we list the file path or the file name, and this is enemy.png. And then to create an image, we're going to method chain this by adding .getImage. This will make an image out of our image icon. Now we need to create a timer. We haven't done that for a while, so we'll finish instantiating this timer. Timer equals new timer. And there are two arguments to pass in for a timer. So we need an integer for the delay of how often this timer fires and does something, as well as an action listener. So let's say we want this to perform an action every 1 second. So this is in milliseconds, the delay. So we'll perform an action every 1,000 milliseconds, 1 second. We also need an action listener. So we'll have this JPanel implements action listener. There are better ways of doing this, but since we're beginners right now, that will be in future videos. So we'll need to add any unimplemented methods. And we have an action performed method. We'll return to our action performed method later. We need to define our paint method, and the paint method is called behind the scenes when we instantiate our panel, because our JPanel is a subclass of the component class. So let's say public void paint, and this has one parameter of graphics. Graphics G. And the first thing we're going to do within this paint method is cast our graphics G object as a 2D graphic, because there's more options available to us with graphics 2D objects. So graphics 2D, we'll call this G2D, equals G, and then we need to cast this. Graphics 2D. And if we want to draw any graphics, we type in G2D dot, and then draw, fill, whatever you want. We want draw image because we want to draw our enemy image. And there are a few different images that take various amounts of arguments. So let's stick with this one for now. This takes an image, some coordinates, and then an observer. So with the observer, we have not covered those yet, so we're going to set this to null. And we have to set an X and Y position. Luckily, we already declared what we want these to be. X is 0 and Y is 0, so we can keep these the same. And this image is called enemy. So this will draw our enemy on our panel. And right now it's in the top left corner. So notice that with this background, we set this to black. Now to actually paint the background, we need to use the paint method of the parent class, also known as the superclass. So before we actually cast this graphic, we're going to call super.paint. And we pass in our graphics G. So this will paint the background for us. And you can see that it's black. So this will paint background. Well, we have our image drawn, but how do we get this image to move? Let's say we want to move this image on the x-axis across the screen. Well, we can use our timer to help us do that. So after every 1,000 milliseconds, 1 second, it's going to perform our action performed method. Now, with our timer, when we instantiate it, we need a delay, which we have, and an action listener. Since we're implementing the action listener interface, we can pass in this. And then we need to start this timer by saying timer.start. So this will start our timer right when we instantiate this panel. So after every 1 second, we can perform some sort of action. Anything within the action performed method will occur. So let's move the coordinates of our enemy that we have. So we have x equals 0 and y equals 0. Let's say we want to move our image on the x axis. So we'll say within the action performed method, x equals x plus our x velocity for our enemy. Now, when we run this, pay attention. It doesn't appear to move, but it actually is behind the scenes. I'm going to resize this window slightly, and you'll see that our image just jumped. That's because we are not currently repainting our window that we have, our panel. So we need to actually call this paint method again every time we update the position of our enemy or any components that it contains. And let's look at this paint method. According to the description, it says that applications should not invoke paint directly, but should instead use the repaint method to schedule the component for redrawing. What we're trying to do is that after we update the position of our enemy, we're attempting to call paint again to redraw the enemy in its new position. However, we instead need to use repaint, according to the description. Repaint in a roundabout, indirect way. We'll call paint for us to redraw all of the graphics that we have. So now this will actually repaint our enemy without us having to resize the window, because when you resize the window, it will repaint everything. But now it just does it for us. Okay, now this enemy is moving very slowly. So let's have our action performed method be called every 100 milliseconds instead of every 1000 milliseconds. So the position of our enemy is updating every 100 milliseconds, but why stop there? Let's set this to maybe 10. That should be a decent speed. So after every 10 milliseconds, this enemy is moving on the x-axis by 1 pixel. However, it's not going to stop, it'll just keep on going into the void. So we'll want to set some bounds. Let's say that when this enemy touches the right border, we want it to go left instead of continuing right. So we'll write an if statement within the action performed method to check to see if x is greater than or equal to our panel width. So we'll write that first. If x is greater than or equal to our panel width, and we declared that up here, and it's 500. If it is, we want to change direction, and one way in which we can do that is to flip the x velocity. So currently it's a positive number, but if we were to set this to a negative number, it's going to go in the opposite direction. So we can say x velocity equals x velocity times negative 1. So when we want this to change direction, it's going to multiply whatever x velocity is times negative 1. So 1 times negative 1 equals negative 1. And then when we run this, we'll have to give it a second to reach the border. It's going to eventually go to the left. However, it measures where this enemy is located in the top left corner. So we'll want to take that into account. We're going to add one thing after panel width. Panel width minus enemy dot get width. And then if we have an image observer, we pass that in, but we don't have one, so we're going to set this to null. So we're checking to see if x is greater than or equal to panel width minus the width of the enemy image that we have. And now, once this enemy touches the right border, it's going to flip direction, which it just did. However, now it's going to continue into the void on the left-hand side. So we'll also need to check to see if our enemy is going to touch the left border, and we can do that using an or operator. So if x is greater than or equal to panel underscore width minus enemy dot get width, or x is less than 0, then we're going to flip our velocity. And now it should just go back and forth forever, and let's test it. Man, I hate awkward silences. Alright, so yeah, it's just going back and forth forever. So when it reaches one of the borders, it's going to flip the velocity to either a positive number or a negative number. Now let's do the same thing with the y-axis, so this will go up and down. It's kind of the same process that we have before. I'm just going to turn all of this into a comment, and then copy and paste it. So make sure to write this before the repaint method that we have. Replace all instances of x with y. Make sure to do the same for the y velocity as well. X velocity and y velocity. And y equals y plus y velocity. Replace width with height. Do the same thing for get width as well. Okay, that should be good. And this will just go up and down forever, but let's check just to be sure. All right, we're good. And then if you were to mix these two, this will now go diagonal right across the screen, and when it hits the corner, it's going to bounce back. And you always have the option of messing with the x velocity and the y velocity. Let's set x velocity to 2. and this will now travel in a different direction and bounce off the borders. Let's finish this video by adding a background image, because right now it's just a plain black background. So I'm going to use this image that I downloaded of space, but feel free to use any image that you want to use. So this is within my project folder, and it is called space.png. I have already declared an image that I'm calling background image, and I'm going to finish instantiating this within the constructor. Background image equals new image icon, and within the constructor for the image icon, we list the file path or the file name. Since this file is within my project folder, I can list just the file name, space.png. I want to create an image out of this. I'm going to method chain by adding .getImage to the end of this. And now I can use my background image as an actual image and not just an image icon. I want to draw this image before I draw the enemy. And I'm going to copy this line and make a few changes. I'm going to draw the background image, and I'm going to place the coordinates for this image in the top left corner. So that is where X is 0 and Y is 0. And we do not have an image observer, so we're going to leave this as null. And now for the moment of truth. The background image that I have is now applied to the background of my graphic. So that's the basics of creating some very simple animations in Java. If you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of simple animations in Java. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.